Good morning students. So in this class we are going to discuss about relation between kinetic energy and momentum. So consider an object of mass m moving with velocity v, have a linear momentum p is equal to mass into velocity, and have a kinetic energy half mv square. So half mv square we can write that v square, that v into v, then multiply and divided by m in both numerator and denominator. So m into m, m square, here 1/2 m. So m squared into v into v, just split m into m, so mv into mv, so 1/2 m mv into mv. So that mass into velocity, that is momentum, so p into p, so it's p into p, p square. So the kinetic energy is equal to p squared by 2m. So this is a relation between kinetic energy and momentum. Just rewrite, p squared equal to 2m into kinetic energy. So the momentum p is equal to square root of 2m into kinetic energy. So you will use in plus 2. So if in a problem that mass and kinetic energy have given, then we can find the momentum, that is magnitude only, because mass and kinetic energy, so here kinetic energy is a scalar, so that mass is a scalar. So in a problem mass and kinetic energy given, the momentum of, you can find only the magnitude. Then we see one problem. So two masses, 2 kg and 4 kg, have the same momentum, 20 kilogram meter second power minus 1, will have the same kinetic energy and momentum, the cosine. So kinetic energy, we know the formula for that, p squared by 2m. So just substitute, that p is 20 into 20, then the mass 2 kg, so 2 into 2. So 20 into 20, 400, 2 into 2, 4. So 4 cancel, you will get 100. So 100 joules. That is the kinetic energy of a first particle. Then second particle, so again 20 into 20, 2 into 4. So 400 by 8, so 100 by 2, you will get 50 joules. So the kinetic energy of the first particle is greater than the second particle, because that kinetic energy is inversely proportional to mass. If mass decreases, kinetic energy increases. So for lighter particle, kinetic energy value is high. For heavier particle, kinetic energy value is somewhat low. So from this we can understand, then we'll have the same momentum. So p is equal to mass into velocity. So it depends upon the mass. Here mass into velocity. So here mass will not have the same speed, because you substitute here 20, then mass, just see. So p is equal to 20, mass 2 into speed, that is speed of 1. So s1 equal to 20 by 2, you will get 10. So 10 meter per second. Then if it is for second one, 20 by 4, that is mass 2 kg, here 4 kg, so you will get 20 by 5. So you will get different speed. So the two masses will not have the same speed, just they have given a line, will not have the same speed, just substitute you will get. So p is equal to mv, so mass is 2 kg and 4 kg, here the same momentum but different velocity. So first particle have 10 meter per second. So velocity is more, means kinetic energy is also more, because kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. So here the velocity is less. Why velocity is less? Here mass is more. So in this class we will discuss what is the relation between momentum and kinetic energy, that is kinetic energy equal to p squared by 2m. Then and also momentum p is equal to square root of 2m times kinetic energy. So okay.